Washington Redskins have a man who needs only 7 receptions to become football's all-time leading receiver. He could set that historic record tonight. The hands of Art Monk have been catching NFL footballs for the past 13 years, rapidly surpassing the totals of the game's finest receivers. Now, only the great Steve Largent is ahead of him. And Art Monk now stands on the brink of one of the most prestigious individual accomplishments in professional football.
I think it's more important to maybe some of my teammates or the media more than myself. Obviously, I am very excited about the opportunity of breaking the record.
John Elway and the Denver Broncos face Art Monk's Washington Redskins tonight on ABC's Monday Night Football. A beautiful autumn evening in the nation's capital, and a pair of familiar landmarks, Washington Monument and the Capitol. Spectacular night as we look into RFK Stadium, where there will be a battle waged tonight. The Denver Broncos are in town to take on the Washington Redskins. Hello again, everyone. I'm Frank Gifford, along with Al Michaels and Dan Dierdorf. Good win for you tonight. Two of the winningest teams in the NFL over the past decade, the Denver Broncos and the Washington Redskins. The Redskins kind of limping in tonight. They're 2-2. They suffered a devastating loss last weekend to the St. Louis Cardinals. They have a lot of nicks. They trail Philadelphia and the Dallas Cowboys in the NFC Eastern Division. Both are 4-1. Meanwhile, the Denver Broncos are 4-1, and they win tonight, and they have a one-game edge over Kansas City in the AFC Western Division. But Al Michaels, they're not playing 4-1 football. They have just had some spectacular performances from their quarterback, John Elway.
Frank, even though they're 4-1, they've given up more points than they've scored. Very few people really believe in this team. What's happened is they won two games through Elway miracle magic at the end. Another game they won, they didn't score a touchdown against Cleveland. They won it on 4 field goals. Their fourth win came against San Diego. So how do they get that respect? Well, certainly they'll get it because they are a big underdog tonight if they can beat Washington at RFK. Now, as far as the Broncos are concerned, they have Elway. This is a team that's been to 3 Super Bowls in recent years, and a team that came within 3 points of going to the Super Bowl last year. Dan, they're coming off a tremendous win against Kansas City and facing a team that's coming off about as agonizing a defeat as any team has suffered recently.
2 fourth-quarter interceptions returned for touchdowns served up by Mark Rippenow. That was the difference in last week's loss to Phoenix. And Mark Rippon is taking a lot of heat here in Washington because of the way he has played. Think back to the year he had last year. 28 touchdowns versus only 11 interceptions. Almost a 3-to-1 touchdown interception ratio. This year, it's the exact opposite. 4 touchdown passes and 7 interceptions. Mark Rippon tonight will face a very strict test in front of this RFK crowd. The Redskins, though, tonight plan to win this game one way and one way only, running the football. Look for it a lot.
And we will see that Washington running attack right away because they'll get the ball. Brad Dalwiso, who's been nothing short of sensational to kick off for the Broncos, 16 of his 19 kickoffs have been touchbacks and make it 17 of 20 for 85%. And so the Redskins will begin their first drive at the 20-yard line. Mark Rippon, MVP of last year's Super Bowl, but as Dan just mentioned, 4 touchdown passes, 7 interceptions, 6 in the last 2 weeks. he has behind him Ernest Biner. Then the posse, the three receivers, Sanders, Clark, and Monk. Warren is the tight end slash H-back. Lachey, Jacoby, McKenzie spells Bostic at center. Schlereth and Simmons. Jeff Bostic, who'd normally be their starting center, had rotator cuff surgery and is probably gone for the season. So a revamped front for the Skins. And Rippon retreats on a straight drop on first down. Hits Art Monk for a 7-yard pickup. So that's one more for Monk, and he's within 5 of tying and 6 of passing Steve Largent. Defensively now, the Broncos play a base 3-4. So Shea, the former Oiler and Dolphin, along with Cragen, who's been very good in the middle, and Kenny Walker. Kroll developing into one of the best in the league. Brooks has been outstanding this year. Mecklenburg and Fletcher. And then Braxton and Henderson are the corners. And the veteran safeties, the hard-hitting Dennis Smith and Steve Atwater. Here is Biner on second down, picking up 2 to the 29-yard line. Mecklenburg, 77, makes the hit. It'll be 3rd down and 1 for the Redskins.
Al, you talked about the revamped Washington Redskin line. They are also very thin. If somebody goes down tonight, they are going to be in deep trouble. Jacoby has moved over to the left guard, as you pointed out, from right tackle. He has played there before. Simmons is over at right tackle. He has played there before. Their problem will be, wouldn't you agree, Dan, if they lose somebody tonight?
Yeah, they are extremely thin. Ray Brown, the one backup, he's nicked. He got hurt last week. And really, the next guy in is Matt Elliott, a 12th round draft choice and a rookie. That's an unusual situation for the Redskin Hogs to be that close to big trouble.
3rd and 1, and that's Biner in motion. Ricky Irvins is the tailback in the play fake, and they're going deep on 3rd and 1. Wide open is Terry Orr. He's inside the 30, inside the 20, down at the 13 by Montgomery.
That is so unlike Joe Gibbs.
Well, but what sets it all up? When you have as formidable a running game as do the Redskins, the play-action passing is to be honored, and that's they honored the run fake, Frank, a little too much.
And they have two safeties, does Denver. Steve Atwater, Dennis Smith, they play like linebackers. They were up at the line of scrimmage, and as you can see, Terry Orr, his only thought was, as his heart was in his throat, don't let me drop this. It was a great call against a team that reads the run and moves up with their safety men so quickly.
A 58-yard pickup and a big hole for Biner, who spins to the 1-yard line. It'll be 1st and goal. He's tackled by Braxton.
That's zone blocking, and the Hogs, thin they might be, but good block by McKenzie, Jacoby, and Schlereth. Big opening.
3 minutes into the game. 1st and goal. Middleton, the fullback, and on a keeper, touchdown.
And Mark Rippon needed this.
Now, Mark Rippon celebrating with his teammates. And you're right, Frank. He did need this, and this whole city needed it. The Denver Broncos, meanwhile, have to be spending a little time over on the sideline defensively saying, guys, now look, let's just pretend this didn't happen. Let's just say this series didn't happen. We're spotting them a 7-point lead. Let's not panic. Let's not lose our heads. Let's just come back and play our game plan. But this was methodical by the Redskins.
Bo Miller's point after. The drive, 80 yards, is 3:06.
Thank you. To all of you attracted by Buick's reputation for quality, but who think a new Buick is beyond your means, may I make the following suggestion? Go see the new Buick Skylark Custom. It is every bit a quality Buick. And as the most affordable Buick for 1993, it makes Buick quality more attractive than ever.
Come on. let me show you where it's at. Come on, come on.
It's a universal truth. Miller Lite's brewed from the start to be the one great-tasting beer that's less filling. It's everything you want a beer to be.
Another unexplained crop formation has been sighted. Looks like there's intelligent life out there, after all.
8 weeks NFL Monday Night Football. The Denver Broncos versus the Washington Redskins. Brought to you by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Remember Buick, the new symbol for quality in America. By Philips, the inventors of the compact disc present Compact Disc Interactive, another first from Philips. By Miller Lite, it's everything you want a beer to be. And by two-day priority mail service from your post office.
Let's take a look at the long gainer by Terry Orr. Here's Orr right here. But look at the confusion here and here on the Broncos as to who's going to play action, but who's going to take Terry Orr. As you can see, this is a blown coverage. Dennis Smith goes upfield. Mecklenburg goes to the other side. And we just have a total blow by the Broncos and their defensive unit. And that can be shattering to their psyche early in a ballgame.
Chip Lowmiller's kickoff is taken at the 11-yard line by Alton Montgomery. And he runs it back 22 yards to the 33, and the kicker, Lowmiller, makes the tackle. John Elway worked his magic again last week, twice now this season, against the Raiders and the Chiefs. He has brought them from behind in the waning moments. He has Gaston Green and Reggie Rivers behind him. Mark Jackson and Derek Russell starting as the wideouts. And Clarence Kay, the tight end. They've got a rookie free agent left tackle, Russell Freeman. Davidson, a former tackle. Parts, Wydell, and the veteran Lanier. Reggie Johnson now gets the start in a slot to the right. They put him in motion on first down from the 33. And Elway to the air. And throws underneath to the 36-yard line. It's a minimal pickup as Derek Russell makes the catch. The second-year receiver from Arkansas, Gouveia, makes the tackle. A base 4-3 for the Skins. Man having another good year with Wilson, Johnson, and Stokes up front. They have Marshall, Gouveia, and Collins, their linebackers. Caldwell, who would be the fourth linebacker, is on injured reserve. Mayu and Mays, and remember, Darryl Green is gone for the year. Copeland and Edwards are the safeties. They're also missing A.J. Johnson from the starting lineup with a fractured finger, but he's in uniform and will play in the nickel. Second and six, and Greg Lewis is in at running back, and that is Lewis with the football going nowhere. Runs right into Kurt Gouveia for a loss of one. Two tackles now for Gouveia.
And a swarming tackle on the part of the Redskins defense, still smarting from that loss we talked about earlier to the Cardinals. They were had such a huge lead going into the fourth quarter, and they blew it with two interceptions for touchdowns, and that has to hurt a team. And a good way to start tonight, though, take your first drive and hammer it in.
Third and seven, Richie Pettibone runs the defense and runs it brilliantly and has for years. Out of the shotgun, Arthur Marshall, a rookie, is in motion. Rivers stays in the block. Elway scrambles. Elway runs into his own man, Parts, because Parts was engaged by Tim Johnson, and the Broncos are three and out on their first possession.
Well, the reason he's engaged with Tim Johnson is Johnson really wasn't attempting to rush the quarterback. Johnson had the spy responsibility that time, hung on the line of scrimmage, and boy, he did it to perfection. See, look at Johnson, number 78. He's not working his way upfield. He just holds his ground, and John Elway, like a fly to sugar, ends up going right to him.
Mike Horan, one of the best in the league, left puts one down to the 27, and a fair catch is made there by Brian Mitchell. 9:50 to go in the opening quarter. Skins on top, 7-0. And now it's time for a regular feature on what's new in the world of sports science and technology.
A look behind the scenes as sports and science converge, brought to you by AT&T. Disabled athletes, like their able-bodied counterparts, have a strong desire to compete and excel. New developments in prosthetics give the disabled even greater opportunities. The unique Quantum Foot gives an amputee a full range of ankle motion and greater flexibility in the sole and toes. The newest advancement involves myoelectric devices, which are controlled by electrical impulses from existing muscles.
CalCrew Painting wasn't saving what they'd hoped since leaving AT&T. Schoenstein Pipe Organ Builders was having trouble getting long-distance calls through on the first try. So like thousands of other businesses, they've come back to AT&T. And we want you back. Switch now and we'll give you credit for 1 month of long distance. And we'll pay to switch you back if you're not completely satisfied. We want you back. Call 1-800-222-0400.
Before we ship a new Buick LeSabre, it must meet an international standard of excellence. If it fails to meet a single electrical check, if the aim of the headlight isn't true, if the seams are not measured to the millimeter, we don't ship it. So if you buy a Buick LeSabre for its quality, you won't be missing the boat, even though it doesn't come by boat.
It's a Pittsburgh party. The Steelers get to test the Bengals' big fight. Division rivals tangle here on Monday night.
We play just 5 minutes, 10 seconds. And as you look at the Lincoln Memorial on a sparkling night in Washington, clear skies, temperature is in the mid-60s, and it's a perfect start for the Redskins. They lead 7-0. After Denver goes three and out, Washington has it back. First down from the 27-yard line, and Ernest Byner cuts it back up to the 34 for a gain of 7. It'll be second and 3. Wyman Henderson, the cornerback, comes up to make the hit.
Again, the opening play that Joe Gibbs called on that third and short yardage has changed the whole thinking on the part of the Denver defense. They use their safeties almost like linebackers, and now they're going to be thinking a little more in a hesitant way about the play pass action. A great call. Terry Orr had one reception coming into tonight's game before that one.
Second and 3, that's Monk in motion. Byner again, and he goes nowhere, and it's a fumble, and it's recovered by the Denver Broncos. Kenny Walker made the hit, makes the recovery after Greg Cragen was the man who pops it loose.
And Walker could have, it appeared to me, he could have gotten up and run with the football. He wasn't down on the ground by a Redskin putting him there. But again, keep in mind, Kenny Walker is deaf and, you know, can't hear a whistle if it did or did not blow. Well, what a solid hit. What an up front, squared up hit by Walker, who forces the hit and recovers the fumble.
Whoa. Cragen pounds it out of there, and Ernest Byner is not a fumbler
in any way, shape, or mean.
At the 31-yard line, big early break for the Broncos as they try to cash in. They're down 7-0. It's sharp in motion. And Elway has it deflected, and it's incomplete. Second down. Wilbur Marshall. Wilbur Marshall, one of those linebackers who works in coverage and blitzes with equal aplomb, and this time he's coming.
Well, he was a weak side linebacker a year ago, and of course you remember him from the days of the Bears when you could find him in your backfield or deep on pass coverage. He can do it all. The complete linebacker having to subordinate some of his talent as he fits into Richie Pettipone's defensive scheme of things and playing that strong side.
Second and 10. From the 31-yard line, Mann puts the pressure on Elway, who then steps up to escape, looks for the sideline, picks up two, and is tackled by the omnipresent Wilbur Marshall. So a minimal gain for Elway. It'll be third and 8. We mentioned at the very beginning that the Broncos have a record of 4-1, but they have been, as you can see, outscored by 5 points. They've given up 34 more first downs. They're giving up almost 100 yards more per game. They've suffered 20 sacks, and the time of possession is about 8 minutes in favor of the opposition.
And until last week, 2 touchdowns in the fourth quarter, they had gone 12 quarters without a touchdown.
Third down and 8. A little dump off to Rivers, who has some blocking, and Rivers seeks that first down, and he's close. He's tackled by Monty Coleman, and you can see where the stick is. It's either fourth and an inch, or first and goal.
And that is
first
a,
and 10.
That's a hustle play all the way by Monty Coleman, who's put in a chase position, from the word go. He's back there pressuring the quarterback, and from the chase position makes that tackle from behind. This is a critical play for the Broncos. They cannot afford to get out of here without any points.
Well, they have not attempted a fourth down play this season, and on fourth and inches, they're going to elect to go for three. It's a 39-yard attempt for David Fredwell, who's been a little erratic this season.
But perfect here. Tommy Maddox did the holding, and Fredwell picks up three. So Reeves didn't want to come away with zero. He changed the Redskin lead to four with 7:40 to go in the opening quarter at RFK.
You probably think the best American car value is some little Econo box you have to settle for, right? Nope. It's a Buick. The luxurious Buick Park Avenue. That's according to the complete car cost guide. They calculated the five-year cost of depreciation, financing, insurance, fuel, maintenance, and repairs, and found that Park Avenue is the best American car value. For a free reprint from the complete car cost guide, call 1-800-4-A-BUICK.
Can't someone pick up my phone?
Terry here.
What's that, Terry? That package you promised never got here.
This isn't Mr. Carey. This is his secretary. Please hold.
Federal Express, I need to check on a package. Fast.
Keep holding, please. I hear Mr. Carey down the hall.
Your package. Only Federal Express can confirm delivery in seconds. Other companies can take days.
That package was delivered at 907, signed for by Mr. Hens.
No, sir.
That's okay.
Federal Express, our most important package is yours.
We've got a bit of an edge with the driver we have. We've got the best driver out there. So it's a matter of the mechanics just not overlooking anything. Al and I stay in constant communication during the race. I have to be aware of what he wants or needs, you know, at all times. I think the small details are is what makes the difference between winning and running second.
30 years ago, the world almost ended. Khrushchev, Kennedy, Castro. One step away, Peter Jennings, what the world didn't know, Saturday.
The Washington Monument in the United States Capitol on this beautiful night in D.C. with 7:40 to go in the opening quarter. Skins on top, 7-3. John Elway taking his team into field goal position. And here's Dalwiso now. 17 of his 20 kickoffs have been touchbacks, and that's his worst kickoff of the season right here. A dribbler down to the 5-yard line, and the Heisman Trophy winner, Desmond Howard, brings it back to the 19 before he is wrestled down. The fumble by Ernest Biner, as Frank mentioned, he doesn't fumble. That was his first of the year on his 102nd touch of the year. That's carries and receptions, and only Emmitt Smith has touched the ball more without a fumble this season. And there is, of course, when it comes to fumbling, even though Ernest doesn't fumble very much.
I'm not going to bring it up. I'm not going to bring it up either.
Yeah.
But it was against Denver, wasn't it?
Yep. In the AFC Championship game a few years back when he was with the Browns. First down at the 18-yard line.
You guys are bad.
Rippon to Biner. And he is tackled for no gain. That's Simon Fletcher in his eighth year out of Houston. Defensive end slash linebacker has done a fine job.
Say what Biner's done since he got here. As we take a look at Fletcher, who can play down on the line or play off as a linebacker. In the nickel, he'll get down into the three-point stance, makes a good move on Biner. Since Biner came here from Cleveland in 89, he has over 2,800 yards, rushing over 100 receptions and 25 touchdowns. And he was traded to Cleveland for running back Mike Oliver.
On second and 10 from the 19-yard line. Rippon with time and then has that deflected. Pass intended over the middle for Ricky Sanders, and it'll be third down.
Even as it is, you hear a smattering of boos from the crowd. You can see, look at it. You won't see a better shot than that. That ball wasn't deflected. That ball just floated funny out of Mark Rippon's hands. He had a wide open Ricky Sanders, and that ball just nosedived.
Sure.
Well, I agree with you, Al. When I saw the flight of the ball, I'm going, it has to be deflected.
When you see an NFL quarterback throw a pass like that, you have to assume somebody got a hand on it. Third and 10. And Rippon's throw is a little high for Sanders. Did he make the catch? Yes, he did. A tremendous catch by Ricky Sanders, who gets tackled by Dennis Smith.
Looky what I found.
What great concentration. You talked to Joe Gibbs about Ricky Sanders. He says, well, maybe Art Monk and Gary Clark, they get a little more puff, but this is the man that makes the big play for them, the play when they need it. And he's done it so often, and this is pure concentration.
It's another bad pass, by the way.
High, loses it right there. He knows he's going to get hit, and he knows all about these two safeties, and one of them right there, Dennis Smith, who can really put a pop on you, and he kept his total concentration on the ball.
Denver knows all about Sanders. Ricky had a tremendous day in Super Bowl 22, and the Skins beat him by 32. Biner picks up four up to the 37-yard line. It'll be second and six. Ricky Sanders, the only player in league history, speaking of fumbles, to handle the ball at least 300 times and never fumble.
Stop and think about that. Don't let that one roll right by you without absorbing that one. 300 handles.
Well, look at those hands a moment ago.
At the 37 at second and six, 5:18 to go, first quarter. Redskins lead 7-3. Takes the Biner. That buys time. Rippon going for Clark, and it is broken up at the 10-yard line by Steve Atwater. Clark had gotten behind him, but Atwater able to race back, and with the pass hanging just enough for him, he breaks it up at the last instant.
Frank, did you notice how that ball started to fall apart about halfway there? It started to get the wobbles about the halfway distance, the halfway mark towards Gary Clark.
And watch Gary Clark pull up right here, Dan.
Yep, he's got to stop for it. If it's a tight spiral like Mark Rippon was throwing like all last year, it's a 14-3 ball game.
Good play by Steve Atwater to be back there in it.
He timed it perfectly, his leap.
Third down and six from the 37-yard line with Monk in motion. And Rippon picks up the first down. Clark has it. He's inside the 40 and nicked tied at the 36 by Dennis Smith. And a flag goes down.
They are
at the spot of a tackle.
Atwater and Smith, they are intimidators.
I don't think there's any doubt, at least in my mind, that that's an accident. I mean, Dennis Smith is trying to make the tackle, and Gary Clark makes a tremendous move to get away from him. And Dennis is saying, hey, I'm sorry, guys. I didn't mean to hit the guy in the head.
It's a personal foul against the Broncos. Gordon McCarter is the referee.
I agree with you, Dan. I mean, Dennis Smith, if he doesn't make this move, Gary Clark is long gone. Coming up right here, a little move to the outside by Clark right there, and Smith is off balance. That's the only move he had.
Actually, that ball in his hand hit Clark. Fire. See, I don't think that's a penalty.
I don't think
that's a penalty. That's a good tackle. Yeah. That is a fine open field. The guy is going to move. The guy's coming at you. He's trying to evade you. I don't agree with that call. I think that's a fine play by Dennis Smith.
Mm-hmm.
The full speed is hard to tell.
Agreed. First and 10 from the 20, and Viner slips down, and then Fletcher comes in to make sure he doesn't get up. Loss of one. 4.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Rippon, one thing about Rippon, I mean, he had a terrible week last week. He made two bad decisions. He is a stand-up guy.
Yep.
Stood there in the locker room after the game, talked to everybody, didn't hide this week during practice. He faces whoever he has to face.
And everybody in Washington knows that he's got the new contract, $3 million a year, and with that comes a lot of scrutiny.
Here's the reverse. Sanders takes it from Biner, and then he slips down on the turf, and Brian Sochet gets credit for the tackle, and that's a loss of five back to the 26-yard line.
He may have 300-plus handles of the ball without a fumble, but he's got a few slips in there.
Another play designed to take advantage of the Denver Broncos defense, which is a very strong pursuing defense under Wade Phillips, and there he is. They do a lot of things, whereas the Redskins are relatively predictable in what they do with their 4-3. With the 3-4 of the Denver Broncos, you never know where they're going to come from. Mecklenburg can be all over the field, as is Simon Fletcher. We talked about that. They change up a lot, but they always pursue.
Third and 16 from the 26. Redskins up by four, late first quarter. Sanders in motion. Griffin's got to get him to the 10 for a first down. He lost one way out of bounds. Gary Clark, the nearest receiver, and he was covered very well by Lilo Lang. And it will be fourth down, and Chip Lohmiller will come in to attempt about a 43-yard field goal.
A timely pass rush by the Denver Broncos. The first real heat that they put on Rippon so far in this very young evening. And it forced Rippon to throw it back off his heels, and he had no chance of completing that.
I bet you Joe Gibbs might be happy this is outside the 40, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, 5 of 9. You saw that for Lohmiller, and his record inside the 40 is abysmal.
1 and 5?
43-yard attempt, and Lohmiller boots it through. And so that penalty, that bogus penalty in our estimation on Dennis Smith, puts the Redskins in field goal range, and they cash in with 3:08 to go in the quarter, and Reeves is talking about just that, 10-3.
It's almost as if someone once said, just in case people like sunshine and water, we'd better make Florida. And we'd better make miles of beautiful beaches and places like St. Augustine and Key West, just in case people want to go to them. There are over 4 million miles of roads in Alamo Territory, all across America. And nationwide, only Alamo gives you all those miles for free, including the ones that run through a state that's named after sunshine.
A terrorist controls the world's most dangerous weapons.
Happy trails.
But there's one weapon he doesn't control. Steven Seagal.
Here come the good guys.
Tommy Lee Jones, Under Siege, rated R. Now playing at a theater near you.
Disaster has struck the Washington Redskins. That's Jim Lachey in the middle being aided by Mr. Jacoby, and this is a disaster. We touched earlier on how thin the Redskins are. Lachey was injured when Dennis Smith fell on his leg on that field goal attempt. And there is Ray Brown, the one backup, Mo Elonwebe, another. And we may see one of those two guys in the game, the next Redskins offensive possession.
Lohmiller's kick fielded at the 4. This is Arthur Marshall, the good-looking rookie out of Georgia, who was so instrumental in their win last week against Kansas City, bringing it back out to the 20-yard line.
This is Jim Lachey right here lined up. Now watch Dennis Smith come up over the top, and he will land right on Jim Lachey's leg. Lachey loses his footing. You see his right leg, and here comes Dennis Smith right there, lands right on the back of the leg of Jim Lachey. And what may be the finest offensive tackle in football is being looked at by everyone on the Redskins medical staff.
Again, they were already minus Jeff Bostic, their center. Rotator cuff surgery this week. And now Lachey shaken up as Denver has it at its 20, first and 10. Mark Jackson is the man in motion, and here is Dashon Green going next to nowhere as he's wrestled down by Tim Johnson, number 78, the 6th-year tackle out of Penn State. Green had a tremendous year, broke in with the Rams, couldn't really get started there after coming out of school as UCLA's all-time leading ground gainer. And then when Bobby Humphrey didn't sign last year, Green got his chance and made the most of it. And they missed a face mask call on that last play, or did they? Yep, they did, sort of.
Yeah, Tim Johnson has the right hand. He's got it on the face mask. He didn't hook it and give it a good yank. I guess the officials are really tuned in to that violent head twist that shows that someone has a hold of your face mask. That wasn't there.
Second and 9. And a hole for Green, who exploits it for about a 7-yard pickup as he takes it out to the 29. It's going to be 3rd and 2. Next Monday night, we go to Three River Stadium in Pittsburgh, and we'll have a chance to take a look at Bill Cowher's club, the Pittsburgh Steelers, against Dave Shula's Cincinnati Bengals. And you're looking at Boomer Esiason, but his status right now is questionable, as Boomer was shaken up yesterday.
Badly bruised passing arm for the Boomer.
Bengals Steelers next Monday night. Third and two at the 29-yard line. A minute and a half to go, first quarter. Elway throws, and reaching behind him is Shannon Sharp, and then he's able to pick up a first down. Nice play by a guy coming into his own as a tight end and H-back. Shannon Sharp, the brother of the Packers' Sterling Sharp.
Big game last week for Shannon Sharp. 9 receptions against Kansas City, where he really arrived, and he is leading receiver for the Broncos coming into the night, but he is either a fast wide receiver or a slow tight end. But they have used him in the as the H-back with a great deal of success.
I remember when we saw him out there in August of his rookie year in a preseason game in Denver. We were all struck by him.
First down at the 33-yard line. Elway buys time and then throws an out that's incomplete. Standing sharp, the intended receiver, but Martin Mayhew was draped over him.
Mayhew has been there. He has played steady ball for the Redskins. One of the few real plus factors when you get down to it and you talk to the Redskins about their defense is Martin Mayhew, and principally because he is one of the few that is not nicked. And taking it upfield for the yardage for the first down is Shannon Sharp. And look at Mayhew come back. Joe Mayhew Gibbs only goes 5'8", and Sharp is 6'3".
Joe Gibbs paid him quite a compliment yesterday, said, and saying, I don't know where we would have been the last 3 years without Martin Mayhew. Lines up and plays every game, and when you have as many people hurt as the Redskins have, it's a valuable commodity.
That was Reggie Johnson who came in late. They're down to 3 on the play clock. And on second and long, Elway throws. Marshall comes up with the football. And Wilbur Marshall has scored.
That ball didn't hit the ground, huh?
No.
What a football player is Wilbur Marshall.
That was an attempt at a screen.
He tips it and catches it and goes in to make it 16-3.
It might have bounced off of one of his own guys.
It bounced off one of his teammates' helmet right back into his hand. Top of your screen, number 58. Gets the hand up. They're trying to set up the screen. Gaston Green looking for the ball. Marshall with the tip. Boom, it bounces off somebody right into the arms of Marshall.
That is marvelous, marvelous work by Wilbur Marshall. The pressure, the bat, and then the concentration and the athletic ability to reach down while you're running behind you and get the ball. That's why the Redskins paid a dear price to get Wilbur Marshall.
Two number ones?
That's right. Not many players in this game, though, guys, are capable of those types of plays.
And he'll play wherever you put him. He was a weak side linebacker for 3 years, and they moved him over to play the strong side because Andre Collins came in and would work better on the weak side. He quietly accepted that, and has just made one of so many great plays.
He's also joined, you know, in baseball they talk about the 20-20 club and the 30-30, et cetera, et cetera, with home runs and steals. He has become the charter member of the 20-20 club. He is the first man in the history of the league to have at least 20 sacks and at least 20 interceptions. And this is 20 right here.
Well, give Richie Pettibone credit for something. When he sees an alignment that's going to force Gaston Green to try to block Wilbur Marshall, forget it. Rush Marshall 10 times, he will make a play 10 times. You are asking too much of Green, who's 5'11", 192 pounds, and not a real stiff bat in terms of his blocking ability. He is not going to keep this guy from the quarterback. No way. That's where a defensive coordinator and his scheme and what he has called and what his defense executes, it's a lot of times unnoticed by people.
17-3, Washington, as Lohmiller's kick taken by Montgomery, and he brings it out to the 26-yard line. Goodyear blimp looking into RFK Stadium in Washington. The Goodyear blimp, Spirit of Akron, providing the scenics. And the Redskins thrilling another capacity crowd here with a 17-point first quarter.
They're saying that Jim Lachey, what, has a sprained right knee, and there's a good sign. He's standing. His return is questionable.
Of course, the Broncos right now are in a world of hurt. Down 17-3.
From the 26-yard line now, Elway throws underneath. Catch is made by Green. Tackle immediately made by Govea. Now, we talked about Wilbur Marshall, and earlier we talked about the equal aplomb with which he both rushes and goes back into coverage. He becomes, as we say, the charter member of the 2020 club. It does go in with an asterisk, though. Sacks were not recorded by the league until 1982, so there could have been some people in earlier years who would have been members, but he is the first official member. That's the quarter, and a pretty good quarter for the Washington Redskins. They lead by 14 and will return to Monday Night Football after this message and a word from our ABC station.
The latest vehicle from GM has no moving parts. It uses no gas. It's made entirely of plastic that turns into steel. The new GM MasterCard. Every time you use it, GM will credit 5% of your purchase toward a new car or truck from GM. That could mean hundreds, even thousands of dollars in savings over and above any other discounts or rebates. And there's no annual fee. The GM card. The new financial vehicle.
It may seem like a dream, but it's not. Two of McDonald's delightful Egg McMuffin sandwiches really are $2. Two for two during breakfast at McDonald's. Hurry in, and please obey all rules of the road. When it comes to value, we say the sky's the limit. Two of McDonald's mouth-watering Big Mac sandwiches for $2. Two for two during lunch and dinner at McDonald's. They're really flying out of here.
This is ABC.
Such peace. Such tranquility and harmony.
Harmony? There's nothing but conflict here. Incompatibility. Hardware at war with hardware. Look, a PBS at state-of-the-art one day, obsolete the next. All that money. And who's responsible? Me. This is terrible. This is horrifying.
Leave your job at work. Use New England Telephone to get the latest technology.
What's a PBX?
Without buying the latest hardware.
Married with Children, weeknights at midnight on WBNY-TV.
We start the second quarter at RFK Stadium in Washington, D.C. as you look at the White House. Al Michaels with Frank Gifford, Dan Dierdorf. Redskins lead 17-3. And the Broncos have it second and seven at their own 30-yard line as the second quarter commences. With an Elway drop back and flip over the middle for a first down to Mark Jackson. He is one of the remaining three amigos. The field is gone, but Jackson's still here and Vance Johnson as well. ABC's Monday Night Football is being brought to you by the GM card, the new financial vehicle.
Did you notice on that pass, even though it was a completion to Jackson, Elway ends up flat on his back. And the first quarter stats are reminding you of who's been dominating this game. 27 total yards for Denver. Elway's been sacked 19 times this season.
Green that time, hit by Govea, who's been a busy man in the middle after a short game.
It's been a problem for the Broncos and other teams trying to compete with the teams from the NFC East. It's clearly recognized as the most dominant conference in football. The Broncos were just pasted by the Eagles a couple weeks ago, and they wanted to prove themselves against the Redskins to show that that manhandling by Philadelphia was an aberration more than anything else. Not the best way to get started tonight to try to change that.
Second and 10 at the 42-yard line. Elway throws. That's caught by Jackson again. He's a little short of the first down as he crosses midfield. Marshall in on the tackle, and it will be third down and a yard and a half at the 49 of the Redskins.
The pacing you were talking about, Dan, was a 30-0 aberration, and Elway had to leave the game late in the game. 8 of 18 and under 60 yards for the night. I think Denver's hoping it was an aberration.
Lewis and Rivers are the running backs. Lewis, the tailback, on this third and short. And here goes Lewis, and he spins his way for a first down and loses the ball. And Mayhew is the guy at the bottom of the pile. Washington has it.
Yeah, I used the term last week talking about the Eagles and how they will go into a frenzy early if you make mistakes. Well, they're not the only team in the league that'll go into a frenzy. The Redskins are putting a frenzy job on the Denver Broncos right now.
And Wilbur Marshall was right in the middle of the action there. He may have been the guy who forced that fumble.
Wilbur going after a Seth Joyner type game for a linebacker on Monday night.
Lewis going up, and here comes Wilbur.
He knocked it out. You're right. He stuck the right hand in there and knocked it out.
From the 49-yard line, Irvin picks up eight, tackled by Atwater.
Mickey only goes 5'7". He was running about 5'1" there, just sliding under tackles, broke about three of them. Let's take a look at him again. He runs low to the ground, low center of gravity. Look at that. He slips right through one of the good tacklers in the league, Dennis Smith. Gets away from another tackle of Michael Brooks. And finally, the other safety, Steve Atwater, makes the stop.
This was the matchup that we had in Super Bowl 22 at Jack Murphy Stadium in San Diego.
It was Timmy Smith that day.
Here's Irvin's again,
but the results are looking very similar.
Denver led that one 10-0, and the next thing you know, it was 35-10, Redskins at the half, and 42-10 at the final gun.
That was Doug Williams, the quarterback.
Yes, sir.
Timmy Smith. Timmy Smith. Few players have evaporated as quickly as he did from the NFL scene. What do you have, 205, 206 yards?
I believe 204. It's still a Super Bowl record, and Ricky Sanders had over 200 yards in reception. First down from the 35, and Irvin gets tackled by Kroll and Smith after a pickup of about two. We have 11 and a half minutes to go in the half, and the Redskins on top 17-3.
There's a genuine player, Mike Kroll, another one there, Dennis Smith. Mike Kroll, the number one draft pick a year ago out of Nebraska. Fourth player taken in the draft. And he just gets better with every game he plays. And I think old Mo Elinowibi is in at left tackle for Jim Lachey. He's in there somewhere.
He's finally in there. He's been on the roster for 2.5 years, and this is his first ever appearance. Second and eight. Irvin picks up about a yard. Mo Elinowibi has been on injured reserve for 2 years. Redskins are noted for that, keeping guys on IR for a while,
i.e. their quarterback Mark Rippon, a couple of years of
his first 2 years
IR. So he absorbed what was going on.
So Elinowibi out of Brigham Young finally makes his first NFL appearance, and it was born in Nigeria. Third and eight at the 33-yard line. Monk in motion. Griffin throws underneath to Irvin's, and then Irvin can fight his way only to the 29-yard line, short of the first down. Brooks and Kroll converge on the tackle, and so you're looking at about a 47-yard field goal attempt for Lohmiller.
Very conservative call on the part of Joe Gibbs. Long yardage, and he throws to the back out of the backfield, and it was the intended receiver, as Rippon didn't even take his eyes off Irvin coming out of the backfield. Well, here's a place where the Redskins love to run a fake field goal, too.
Fourth and three. It's a 46-yard Lohmiller attempt. Rutledge puts it down, and Lohmiller hit it straight, but a little short.
This is not the Lohmiller that we recall.
No. Right on target, but not enough. 9:30 to go, and it's still 17-3.
Until now, some thought high maintenance was an unavoidable expense of high performance. Change is in sight. Introducing the NorthStar system by Cadillac, with a 295-horsepower V8 engine so advanced, its first scheduled tune-up is 100,000 miles. So while others promise the world, Cadillac gives you the equivalent of a trip around it four times over. The North Star System by Cadillac. Changing the way you think about American automobiles.
While the Cold War is ending, another war is now upon us. In this new war, the enemy is not the red flag of communism, but the red ink of our national debt, the red tape of our government bureaucracy. The casualties of this war are counted in lost jobs and lost dreams. As in all wars, the critical issue to winning is leadership. In this election, you can vote for a candidate who has proven his leadership by making the free enterprise system work, creating jobs, building businesses. A candidate who is not a business-as-usual politician, but a business leader with the know-how to expand the tax base, reduce the national debt, and restore the meaning of made in the USA. The issue is leadership. The candidate is Ross Perot. The choice is yours.
College football lineup, those of you in the East and Midwest, at noon Eastern time, Boston College against Penn State or Auburn against Florida. Out West, UCLA, Washington State starts your day at noon. Then the second half, Alabama, Tennessee, Michigan, Indiana in the Eastern and Central portions, and Cal USC at 3:30 Pacific out West, a Saturday on ABC Sports.
You'll be doing a little moonlighting there?
Mm-hmm. Bears Trojan from the 28-yard line. Here's Elway. And he's run out of bounds by Wilson. That's an open downfield.
Very unusual for Elway's receivers. None of them, although they saw him in trouble, came back to him. Deep downfield, they continued on their patterns. Elway had nowhere to put the football.
There is Darryl Green in the jacket behind A.J. Johnson. Johnson injured, but he'll play tonight in the nickel. And a look at the finger of Johnson. He suffered a compound fracture, and they had thought about putting him on an injured reserve, and he said, I can play. Meanwhile, Green is probably done for the season. He broke his arm in week two. Second and 10, Elway throws. Catch is made by Sharp. He's tackled at the 30-yard line. Andre Collins is there. And it will be third and, let's call it, to seven.
John Elway got some good news. His father, Jack, signed on with the Denver Broncos as a scout. He's actually going to go on the road and check out the team the Broncos are going to play on the next week. John's father, the former coach at Stanford and other schools, now in Denver with the Broncos.
Back in the old World Football League.
Yeah,
the Frankfurt Galaxy, I believe. On third down and seven, Elway throws to Sharp, and Sharp fights but can't make the first down. Comes up about 3 yards short. Tackle is made at the 35-yard line, and the Broncos are forced to punt. Mayhew is there to finish off the play.
Redskins turning loose the blitz once again. Elway had no choice. Couldn't look downfield. Had to go to the checkoff man. It was Sharp, and he's short of the first down.
So the Broncos keep struggling offensively. Remember last week they scored 2 touchdowns in the last 2 minutes to beat Kansas City. Before that, they hadn't scored in 12 quarters, hadn't scored a touchdown.
Physically, guys, they just don't seem to be capable to pound out a physical ball control drive. When it has to be done by passing the football to continually get your first down, you're not going to do it with a great deal of consistency.
Moran. Punt, fair caught at the 23-yard line.
The greatest variety of dinosaurs were alive during the Cretaceous period, which was toward the end of the Mesozoic era.
What if we said you could go to the Smithsonian anytime you wanted without leaving your living room? And what if we told you you could hold an entire pinball arcade in the palm of your hand?
Wow! Cool.
Philips, the inventors of CD technology, have captured some of the most entertaining and educational experiences imaginable and put them on a new kind of compact disc called CD Interactive. Philips CD Interactive transforms your television from something you look at and listen to into something you actually experience. CD Interactive, available only on the Imagination Machine, the world's first CDI player, and another first from Philips.
Until now, some looked abroad for a high-performance luxury automobile. But change is right before your eyes. Introducing the Cadillac Northstar system. With its 32-valve Northstar V8, it becomes an extension of the driver's will, generating 295 horsepower, while affording impressive levels of quietness and refinement. The Northstar system by Cadillac. Changing the way you think about American automobiles.
In the AFC Central, nothing comes easy. The Cincinnati Bengals roar into Pittsburgh to battle the Steelers. Next week on ABC's Monday Night Football.
Denver hasn't gotten a lot of respect despite a 4-1 start, but if you go back to the third week of last season, they've got the best record in the National Football League. It's 15-4, and the Redskins are second, and Buffalo is 15-5 since week three of 91. Tonight it's been the Redskins by 14 to this point, as Irvin on first down picks up a first down and is run out of bounds after a pickup of about 11, and a flag is thrown at the end of the play. Wyman Henderson is the guy, I think, who is the recipient of the penalty.
If you're Wyman Henderson, it's one thing to get 15 yards for a personal foul, which is what he's going to get. But if you're going to get the 15 yards, at least be the guy that delivers the blow. Wyman Henderson is going to get it put to him by
Personal
Ricky Irvin.
Foul, unnecessary roughness, late hit, number 24, defense, 15 from the dead ball spot, first down.
That's getting the worst of both ends of the stick.
Couldn't very well call it on Ricky Irvin's, could they? Irvin's a third-round draft pick in 91, a real steal for the Redskins. Had a injury problem his senior year at USC, had a great junior year, and he went in the third round. He's turned into a real fine. Redskins first down at the 47. Irvin tackled by Braxton. He picks up another four, takes it to the 44-yard line.
That's the dangerous part of the old counter play, where the two offside linemen pull around. That play was designed to go around right end. Ricky Irvin's took it all the way back around the left end and picks up 4 yards with it. That's the kind of freedom the backs have in that slow developing play. If the defense over pursues, a talented guy like Irvin Franks takes it all the way to the backside.
And that's his strong suit to the cutback. Second and six. Griffin buys time with the fake. Goes wide open. Touchdown Clark.
They let Griffin again.
Beautifully timed out.
Yeah.
Beautifully timing is all right too.
Beautifully timed out and horribly defensed by Denver.
He beat Henderson.
Yeah. That's a combination of good work by Washington and very, very subpar work by the Broncos.
Gary Clark has beaten the best over and over. One of the great receivers in the game today. Look at the protection Griffin has. This one is a tight spiral all the way. Dead on stride. Henderson no chance to get in the play. And Henderson, unfortunately, tied one-on-one with one of the great receivers in the game.
Lohmuller for the point after. And they'll strike up hands of the Redskins one more time at RFK. 6:30 to go, first half, 24-3, Redskins.
For 2 weeks a year, Kappa's Case in Canada is home to us, Larry, Rim, and yours truly, Sue. The perfect place to cold weather test for new Saturn wagons? Yes. Las Vegas? No. This trip, though, we had a side project, an idea to improve the performance of our ABS-equipped cars on slick surfaces. And after a few late nights, we had it. Integrated traction control. We learned a lot that trip, including the fact that Larry can't make coffee. The most innovative design to come down the runway isn't in Paris. It's the new Pittsburgh International Airport, where every day, nearly 500 U.S. air flights come together at the world's most modern connecting terminal. If you think Paris is sophisticated, wait till you see Pittsburgh. USA begins with you.
Tomorrow, why would a major college football team hire a woman as a strength coach? When you meet her, you'll know why. On ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
Well, the Bronco secondary getting picked apart.
It happened last week in Kansas City. Mm-hmm. They scored a couple wide open touchdowns on play action as well.
Will Miller's kick is fielded a yard into the end zone by the rookie Arthur Marshall. And he brings it back out to the 20. Warren Bowles in on the tackle, and let's take a look at that last touchdown.
Here are nine people for the Denver Broncos up in close proximity to the line of scrimmage. Now let's go ahead and roll this. There's the play action. And if we could stop it right about here, look at this pocket. Look at this. This guy's on the ground. Everyone else is accounted for. Two guys in limbo, three guys in limbo, and you've left Henderson all alone. I mean, if you are going to have that many people on the line of scrimmage, you better put more pressure on the quarterback than the Denver Broncos did that time on Mark Griffin, or that will happen to you over and over again.
First down from the 20-yard line. They give it to Reggie Rivers, and he takes it out to the 22. Well, the Broncos are a team that has now scored two touchdowns in 14 quarters. They've been unable to get any running game going this season to speak of. Coming into the game, Gaston Green averaging a paltry 2.6 yards per carry. And here they are down by 21 on the road.
And of all places, in RFK. Mm-hmm. And look at that, 1.6 yards per rush. getting cold on the Broncos sideline here.
Second and eight. Green goes nowhere.
Well, now we'll make it 1.2 yards per carry. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's tough to run the draw if you're Denver, because you usually are having somebody hanging in there as a spy when you hand off the draw. The spy, of course, for John Elway. When you hand off the draw, that man is going to fall into the draw. Dangerous threat, but he can't do it all. Sacked 19 times coming into the night.
Third and eight. From the gun. After looking off Vance Johnson, he goes the other way for Shannon Sharp, and Sharp wants a flag and still doesn't get one. Sidney Johnson was the defender.
Well, that was either one of the great plays of all time or pass interference. But he timed that out beautifully. They didn't get the flag. Sidney Johnson in there in the nickel, making perfect contact, apparently.
You've got two men back, Brian Mitchell, and he's flanked by Desmond Howard. And remember, the two of them hooked up against Atlanta as Horan juggles the snap and then gets away a poor kick.
But that'll have to come back.
And a flag goes down.
Well, when he juggles the ball like that, his guys leave early.
Two flags.
Yeah.
Back.
I mean, you have ineligible men downfield. They leave before he kicks it. So that's one of them.
Yep.
There may be multiple fouls here.
In fact, there are three flags on the grass right now.
Well, if they're not big ones, they might want to take the football.
Meanwhile, let's go back about the non-interference call here on Sidney Johnson.
I'll tell you, that's pretty good.
Yeah, that is pretty good.
Yeah, when you look at it from that angle, you did not see the contact by Johnson, and their bodies touch. No doubt their bodies touch, but you don't see it being a jarring contact.
Ineligible downfield, number 31, kicking team.
Holding, number 20, receiving team, during the kick. The penalty's offset, repeat fourth down.
Now Boyd Mays for Washington, the recipient of that penalty. So a break for Horan because the kick was a bad one. And again, you've got Mitchell and Howard both dropping back to accept the punt. And a much better kick this time. Taken at the 30-yard line and run back to the 40-yard line by Howard.
On the called back kick, I guess we had a heck of a hit take place down the field. Number 21 there in the orange is Lilo Lang. Whoa! That's Danny Copeland of the Redskins. That is as violent a hit as you will ever see in the NFL. Whoa!
The Postal Service would like to present two-day priority mail. That's delivery in just 2 days of up to £2 for just $2.90.
Two.
Remember.
Two.
2 days.
Two.
£2.
Two.
$2.90.
Two.
Two. Two. Two-day priority mail from your Postal Service.
We deliver for you.
For pickup service, call 1-800-222-1811. By the time Dad was finished talking, I was scared to death of buying a car. I know how these people operate, he goes. So when Dad announced he was coming along, I didn't stop him. Pretty soon, I even thought he really knew what he was talking about. Scary, huh? Then I had this idea. Dad goes, let me do the talking. But at Saturn, there were no hassles, even over the price. The thing about Dad is, he likes to feel useful, and that's cool.
Tackles Penn State. Auburn meets Florida. For Out West, UCLA takes on Washington State. It's high noon regional action Saturday on ABC Sports.
Lilo Lang on the right. Danny Copeland sitting on the bench there on the left. And we're going to take another look at that because believe me, anybody who's ever played the game appreciates a hit like that. Even the recipient. I know that sounds strange, but it's true.
Not strange to me. First and 10 at the 40-yard line, I'll bet it. Here's Biner going nowhere. He's tackled behind the line by Brooks.
Well, it's a good, clean hit. Nobody gets hurt. Again, watch Copeland come in from the left. Lang never saw him coming. First thing that hits the ground are your shoulder blades.
Then watch what happens, though.
Nobody gets hurt. And now this is after the second kick. Lang is looking for Copeland.
He's looking for a truck.
But now what? He's looking for Copeland. There he sees him. And you know what he says? Nice hit.
Nice hit.
Nice hit.
But fortunately, he can still get it out.
And he says, next time, it'll be you.
Hey, that's... So after Lilo Lang gets laid low, here's Biner. Up to the 39-yard line.
Lilo laid low.
I think that was the noise he was hearing after he was hit. Lilo Lang. Reagan and Mecklenburg in on the last hit, third down. 3:45 to go, and here comes Lang in their nickel and dime.
I know there's a lot of people out there that think I'm crazy for talking about
it. Yeah, one right next to you.
But player, Frank,
in every the sentence, guys, I didn't live to play that game to get hit like that.
Oh, it's all right. He's all right. Lilo's fine.
I had that in my past, as a matter of fact.
Well, you got hurt, and that's the only reason we're having a little fun with that, because nobody got hurt. Obviously, if someone would have been hurt, we wouldn't be laughing about it.
They're flying up to the line of scrimmage, dropping back into coverage. Third down and 11. Griffin off the reverse roll, throws. The catch is made by Art Monk. That's his second of the night. He's short of the first down. And Monk, who has now caught a pass in 137 consecutive games, keeps moving in on Steve Largent. He needs four to tie Largent for the all-time reception mark and five to surpass him.
What an incredible athlete out of White Plains High School.
playing against our executive producer of ABC Sports, Jack O'Hara. Jack was a tight end, linebacker. And he recalls his days back in 1973 going as Art Monk. He went actually as a running back up to Syracuse and had over 1,000 yards rushing. And he is on the threshold of immortality.
Wonder if Jack ever got hit like that.
Like Lilo?
Might be why he went into television.
Kelly Goodburn.
That's what happened for television.
His first punt of the night goes into the end zone for a touchback. And the Broncos will get it with 2:36 remaining in the first half. And very much in the need of putting 7 points on the board before the half. They're down 24-3. They've been unable to generate anything offensively now for 3 weeks outside of the last 2 minutes against Kansas City. And facing a most formidable task tonight at RFK Stadium in our nation's capital, Spirit of Akron. In the skies above. Longtime home of the Redskins, but Washington would like to move. And there's been no movement on a prospective new stadium in Virginia. That's hung up right now for the moment. Nothing happening.
That's the problem in RFK. When you're on the road, it's the problem in Denver, too, if you're the opposition.
First and 10, and going nowhere is Rivers. On a first down play, he is stopped by Tim Johnson. Second and 10. Broncos in this first half, a punt after the first possession, then a field goal, an interception, a fumble, and two more punts.
That's pretty. Mm.
Second and 10. Elway throws. The catch is made by the stretching Shannon Sharp. That's enough for a first down. He stays in bounds, and that's going to take us to the two-minute warning.
If you're looking for bright spots for Denver, the emergence of Shannon Sharp has to be one of them. Good-looking player.
Only Delta gives you more flights from over here to over there. Only Delta flies you nonstop to more cities from over here to over there. In fact, only Delta flies you nonstop to more cities in Europe than all these airlines combined. Delta, we love to fly, and it shows the world over.
Can't someone pick up my phone?
Gary here.
Carrie, this is his secretary. Please hold.
Federal Express, I need to check on a package fast.
Keep holding, please. I hear Mr. Carrie down the hall.
Only Federal Express can confirm delivery in seconds. Other companies can take days.
That package was delivered at 907, signed for by Mr. Hanson.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
Federal Express, our most important package is yours.
July 1992, Oldsmobile goes further than any other car company to redefine quality. Further than the lab, further than the test track, the Oldsmobile Achieva went 100,000 miles against Honda Accord and Toyota Camry in a real-world test. Independent test results prove Achieva outperformed Accord and Camry in total cost, which includes maintenance, repair, and operating costs. Achieva, quality redefined. From the company that went far enough to prove it. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering.
Capital on this Monday night in our nation's capital, and there is the posse. Monk tonight, two catches. Sanders has one. Clark has two.
The three senators from this team. A lot of talent there. And to think they've got a Heisman Trophy winner waiting in the wing.
Yeah. Desmond Howard.
They don't use that four wide receiver much, but you kind of think that once Howard, who reported very late, gets a chance to work in, they could be very effective with a four wide receiver offense.
First down from the 31, and Elway gets sacked by Fred Stokes at the 24-yard line. That's three sacks tonight for the Redskins. And Reeves says he wants a timeout.
Stokes blowing right by the rookie, Russell Freeman. John doesn't see him.
No. They just keep going, and there's a terrible-looking play. But that's an incomplete pass, a little shovel pass intended for Sharp. And since it was a forward pass, it's incomplete. Second and the third down.
They don't even block Fred Stokes. Fred Stokes just smothers John Elway. And
and watch the left side of your screen. They don't even block him. The left tackle, number 68, Russ Freeman, blocks down, and Stokes is untouched.
Third down and 17 with 1:47 remaining in the half. Elway goes back to the other side, hits Shannon Sharp, but he is stopped short of the first down by Martin Mayhew.
That's a design play with Shannon Sharp. Blocking at the line of scrimmage, drifting out into the flat. Elway rolling far to his left, looking downfield and then firing back to Sharp, and the Redskins were all over it.
And the Redskins are going to take a timeout because they're going to get the ball back after the punt.
Another play by Mayhew. He was not fooled.
We have 1:32 remaining in the first half, and the Redskins have two timeouts left. A 21-point Washington lead, and as far as you look at Jack Kent Cook, the owner of the Washington Redskins and the former owner of the Los Angeles Lakers,
sees himself
Kings
on the monitor.
Yeah, owns a number of horses. Pretty happy man tonight. One thing about the Broncos, they're about finished when it comes to coming east. 30-0 in Philadelphia, 24-3 thus far in D.C. tonight. The Rams kick takes a Denver bounce and rolls dead at the 23-yard line. Washington has it with two timeouts and a minute 20 left on the clock. Coming up at the half tonight, stay with us because Deion Sanders will be joining us, and we'll talk about his day yesterday and his immediate future with the Falcons and the Braves. And you know what he did yesterday, and a look at Art Monk as well. Our halftime features tonight from RFK Stadium, and you caught a glimpse of Mr. Sanders.
Never has one traveled so far to do so little. Very impressive that he would make the attempt.
At the 23-yard line, gain of six. Well, he didn't do much last night in Pittsburgh because he didn't get into the game, but he had a full schedule in Miami, not only playing the entire game defensively, but running back kicks and even catching a pass as he got in on offense.
Just dehydrated to the point where he needed a couple bags of fluids intravenously after the game. Yeah, I get exhausted watching that commercial he does.
Sanders makes that catch, and they take a look. Is it enough for a first down? And they say no. Third down and inches at the 32-yard line. As Griffin can't pick up the first down, lofting it for Biner, who was covered by Kroll in the 38 ticks remaining. Washington on a fourth and inches situation here, pretty much compelled to punt.
I don't see where they're in a position to take unnecessary chances.
Ah.
Be interesting in the locker room at halftime for the Denver Broncos because they have been able to show absolutely nothing. I saw the look on your face
tonight.
Saw the look on your face, Al. It's kind of a cavalier call by the Redskins.
Third and inches.
Yeah.
Strange call. Yeah.
24-3.
Yep.
You're dominating the line of scrimmage.
Goodburn's kick, fielded at the 31-yard line by Arthur Marshall. And Marshall gets gang tackled up at the 35-yard line, so Elway has that much time remaining. And he has all of his timeouts.
I'll tell you who is not getting cocky about this lead is Joe Gibbs, who watched his team lead 24-6 after three quarters last week against the Cardinals, only to see that disappear in a 27-24 loss.
You know, we've seen a lot of comebacks. That had to be as improbable as any comeback ever. 17-0 at the half, 24-6, and the crowd ready to leave. And the next thing you know, well, you've got two interceptions, run back for touchdowns by Robert Massey, and then an 85-yard Phoenix drive. Elway throws incomplete. That 8 of 5 seconds. Wilbur Marshall put the pressure on that time. He's been all over the joint.
And they're harassing him once again. And Elway had to unload it because he knew Marshall was behind him. He felt the presence. He'd just blown by him. And he had to unload.
The only thing I can say about that comeback that Phoenix engineered, if Mark Rippon should serve up a couple softballs tonight that get returned for touchdowns, somebody better call the National Guard to remove him from this stadium. A couple of fourth quarter interceptions for touchdowns would not sit well with this RFK crowd at all.
Second and 10.
Poor John's getting killed.
Yep, he's getting killed. Charles Mann that time decks him.
They're just taking turns.
And the secondary was doing its job as well. He tried to force it in amongst the quartet of Redskins. Third down.
This time the pressure comes from his right. Right by the tackle, and Charles Mann all over John Elway. And John Elway never complains, never beefs about it, never goes public about the beatings he's taken over the years. And he has taken some.
Third down and 10. Elway fires, and that is nearly intercepted at the 50-yard line by Brad Edwards, and there's a marker down behind the line of scrimmage at the 29, and it's a hold against Denver.
Better to hold than let your quarterback get hit.
That's the bad news. The good news for the Broncos, only 11 seconds
76
left.
Offense, penalty declined, fourth down.
Ken Lemire had just been beat by Charles Mann on the play before, and he was not going to, he's a 12-year veteran, he was not going to let John Elway take two shots, so he knows the only way he's going to keep that man out is hold him, and that's exactly what he did, as Mann had beaten him on the play before, number 71.
No quarterback will ever go up to his offensive lineman and complain to him about holding, unless he held the guy, and the guy's still hitting. Then he might.
Horan's kick is dropped by Mitchell, loose ball, but recovered by the Redskins inside the 15 with 1 second left on the clock.
Boy, that's the kind of night it's been for the Redskins. In total contrast to what that fourth quarter was last week against the Cardinals. Everything is going Joe Gibbs and the Redskins' way. A little bobble. Maybe perhaps taking his eyes off the football just a little quickly is Brian Mitchell.
And the recovery here made by Ty Bowles, and that saves Washington 3 points. Otherwise, with one tick left, if Denver recovers, it's an easy Treadwell field goal. So the first half will come to an end with this play, barring a penalty. Nothing like a wide open formation. Kneeled down by Rippon. Skins are nearly perfect in the first half. They lead it by a score of 24-3. Deion Sanders live at halftime. We'll return with halftime activities after this message from the National Football League. And a word from our ABC station.
I care about my...